All right, guys, today we are going to talk about watering. And I am here at the greenhouse at the high school to show you a couple of things. So the first thing you need to do is you need to figure out when your plant needs to be watered. And plants will give you some signs that you can look at. So probably the easiest thing to look at is the color of the soil. All right? Here we have two different plants that are have different amounts of moisture in the very same kind of soil. And you can see that the purple heart has much darker colored soil, and the little succulent has much lighter colored soil. So right away, without even touching it, I can tell you that the purple heart is much wetter in terms of the dirt. But we also have to look at what the plant is telling us. Sometimes it's really easy and sometimes it's not. So here we have a little spider plant, and you can see that these leaves are starting to fold in half. This is a very dry plant. In a minute, I'm gonna water it, and then you guys will see sort of how to do that correctly. But more common than that is overwatering. So if you look at this plant, we have some parts of the same plant in this pot that are really happy, and some parts that it's been a while, but those are completely not gonna come back. Those were overwatered. And I will tell you that I haven't been to the school in quite a while. I'm thinking somebody came in and tried to help me out. But this soil is pretty damp. I can still feel that it's damp. So you should also be practicing touching the soil. And if you feel dampness, it might be good unless the plant's telling you something else. This is another example. This little plant is a mango. And you can see that the leaves on the bottom are really dark and they're all curled up. And when you look in this soil, and then the other thing is up at the top, these leaves are starting to come back, but they're kind of yellow. So this plant actually, a mango is a tropical plant, got really overwatered a couple months ago, and probably root rot messed these leaves up. And it's taken a long time for this soil to dry out really good, and now it's starting to come back. All right, here's another thing you might see. These are two plants that are the exact same age in the exact same size pot. And the one on the left is, the leaves are a lot darker green. But also, if you look along this stem, the space between the nodes is much narrower than this plant. Over here, you have a really long inner node on these stems, and that's because this plant, the one that's much taller, kind of got overwatered, and this plant just kept reaching and reaching. So this is obviously a little bit better looking of a plant. So the next thing that we're going to think about is how the water enters the soil and how much water to use. So I have a watering can here, and you have to go pretty slow. And I want you guys to see the water is already coming out the bottom of this plant. But if you look at the top, there's still some parts that are really dry and some parts that the water is pooling. Okay? So something that you can do if you're really careful is you can take the plant out and you can take a look at the soil and the root system underneath. And I can see this plant has a lot of roots, but all that soil on the side is still completely dry. So in that case, in order to do a good job of watering this plant, we can't just pour water in until it flows out the bottom. We have to do something else. Take a look over here. This is an aquarium of pretty dry soil, and I'm gonna pour some water on the top. And I'm pouring quite a bit. And what I want is for you guys to look at the sides and watch the water move into this soil. And what you'll notice is you can't even see it yet. Those dark spots are where the soil, the water is. And it takes a long time to move down and saturate it. And there's still a lot of parts of this soil that are very dry. And I just dumped an entire, close to a gallon of water on this plant. Now, I also want you to think about the tools that we use. We're almost never going to use something like this to water plants. This is really to clean something off. This has way too much pressure. So instead, we're going to use something. This is a water breaker. So it goes onto the end of, so this is a long wand so that we can reach up high. And if I want to put it into a basket, I can get this down in by the roots and put the water right where we need it instead of getting wet. All right, now a lot of people wonder, why would you put water in a watering can and then water? Well, let me show you. When I pour the water into here with this, it doesn't really move. Okay, this is very dry soil yet. Okay, but I'm gonna show you even just a hose that already has a breaker. Do you see how much soil moves? And I didn't even turn it on full blast. You can actually move a lot of soil away from the roots of a plant and cause problems if you do that. So it's intentionally much slower with the watering can. So if you aren't sure about how much moisture a plant has or how much it needs, you can use feel, and if it feels damp, it's probably wet enough. Or this is a pretty cheap tool that you can buy at pretty much any garden center. And basically, you stick it into the soil, and when it's on moisture, it'll give you a reading about how much moisture that plant has. And right now, it is in the pretty green zone. Okay? So I wouldn't probably water that plant a lot more. This, by the way, is an avocado that grew by itself in my little aquarium, and it's a great little demonstration plant. They don't like a lot of water, but you water them a lot infrequently. So over here, we have sand, and you can see that it says very dry. I'm gonna let you watch again. When I pour water, sand moves water through the system very fast. And it takes a lot of water to dampen. And can you see how much soil is moving just from the pressure of my watering can? If the roots are down deep, it still hasn't reached the bottom. So that's it. I'm going to give you guys some more tips a little later on in a lesson in class. But now you've seen some things firsthand.